strange. I wonder if there were carvings at some point. A war memorial here. People in this area that... memory of those from Fortinghall district who fell in the Great War. It's a lovely big Celtic cross. Okay, Commonwealth War Graves. Let's go in and see what's what. What's that over? Some old gravestone. Spelling crossbones and whatnot. And an hourglass. Words in Gaelic. I wonder how old some of these stones are. Here's the church. The oldest stones are usually near the church, eh? You would imagine. Some of the older ones there. Back. But anyway, oh, buzzards. Got the buzzards up there. I don't really see them, but you might hear them. Up ahead stands Fortinghall's oldest resident, a 5,000-year-old yew tree. There we go, it's carved in stone, so it must be true. Imagine those who have passed this way before.
Okay.
Stone Age man. Yep. Bronze Age man. No woman, just man. Reindeer, boar and wolf, yeah. Aye, we had all wolves and things in this country. The Picts. The Scots. Or Romans, had the Romans, and the Christians, warriors, explorers, scholars, kings and queens. Here we are. Also, if you hold that in, you should be able to read it if you pause. So all the things that came and went. Pyramids, Stonehenge, Muddy Bar, Huts, Man on the Moon. So yeah, the pyramids were built 2,000 years after this tree was planted. Stonehenge was 1,000 years after. That's a wee depiction of the Crannog. Now these are little structures that were built in Lochs. The people that would live farm land would stay in these and keep their livestock in them as well and be bridge going out. They were also quite sort of defensive as well. If you thought your lands were going to get taken, you would go in there. Plenty of food, obviously plenty of water because it's built on the loch, and you would haul up the bridge and the beddies wouldn't be able to come and take all your stuff. So there's quite a lot of crannogs, and there's the Crannog Centre around the south side of Loch Tay. Here it is. Tree in the world, but really quite ancient. That's what's 5,000 years. It's split into two. And local weddings and funerals and things would pass through the middle. Pass through the middle here. Going into the church where they built this. Climbed on and bits broken off and whatnot, so it's now been sort of fenced in. A couple of folk in chilling out, relaxing. Maybe soaking up the ancient vibes or something. There it is. 5,000 years. It's closed, it's only opening Friday evenings. An old phone box, old red phone box, a couple of houses. Oh, wander back out, try not to stand on any graves. Got a thing about that, just running across the top of graves. Well, what else? There we go, let's have a look at the front of the hotel. Really nice. It's carved, the name of the hotel's carved in stone above the door. Gate closed. Nice valley down here. Sort of lush grass for all the livestock and sheep. So you can see why this glen would have been inhabited for such a long time. Builder. I wonder if there's a date on it. When it was built. We'll see, there might be something near the door. It's quite often a date thing. There we go, we can see the some carbon. Bar, but it's called the U. It's nice in there. I had soup. I had a bowl of soup in there one day. It was half a fight. So, the wee post box, telephone box. A lot of these old phone boxes have now got, you know, if they're in villages, I think they've got defibrillators in them or a free library. You go in. Do book swaps. Read a book for somebody else gets a read at it. When do they pick up? Monday to Friday, 1 PM. Telephone. See. There might be folk from other countries watching this and they don't know what's going on inside. Jesus, that door's heavy. This one doesn't stink of pee. These things, quite often in cities and towns and things, used to be used as urinals. There it is. Phone box. Yeah. Stick your money in there and dial your number and that connection. You get your change at the bottom. Yeah, it's still working. That's that. Now, minimum call, 60 pence. Hey, right. And just noticed in here, look, there's some snails living in here for the winter. Nice wee shelter for them, right enough. So that's what the inside of an old telephone box looks like. Never seen one before. Right. Gas Land Rover, that's quite easy. Ideal. Always fancy one of them. Had a Land Rover Discovery at one point, big V8 thing. It was running on gas. Still quite expensive to run. doggy go. There's a doggy. Tick. A greyhound or something. Or a whippet. Hey boy. That's his back at the bike. So, time to change the battery. And, I'll probably pick you up again on the south side of Loch Tay. So, catch you all in a bit.
I've stopped here on a wee bridge over the river, whatever. I don't know what it is, the Tay maybe? Don't know. Anyway, I thought I'd stop you. Have a wee look round at this metal bridge. Don't know if you could hear me, I've still got my helmet on. Yeah, so there we go. River. Royal Enfield. Lovely wee house with a coal fire going. Bottom of the hill. Imagine this being your backyard there. That'd be brilliant. There's a van. Anyway, I'm going to get back on my bike and head down the road.
Well, folks, I'm going to end the day here. I was going to go along the south side of Loch Tay along the single track road, but it takes a hell of a long time to go along there. So, we're running out of daylight, the sun's starting to disappear, so I'm going to go back along the north side of the loch and head home. I'll probably split this video down into a few smaller ones. There's quite a lot of footage on the camera already, so I'll probably break it down into two or three shorter videos. And so I'll add this on the end of them, just to let you know that the day's done and I'm going to batter on back down the road. I don't want to be mucking about with the camera anymore, I just want to get home. Because I'm tired, I'm cold, and I've done enough. So yeah, I started filming at Loch Lubnig, then went up Glen Ogle, and then down to Killin, came through Killin, along the north side of Loch Tay, went to the Fortinghall yew tree, and then I've stopped here in Kenmore. So, yeah, that's it. Day's done. Gonna head up the road. Back to the bike. Mayfair Village, Kenmore. I still haven't found anywhere open for a cup of coffee though, so that's that. There we go. It's actually, the helmet's going to blow off of there. I'll put it down on the ground. So a last wee parting shot of the bike. There's Father Brown. He's had a wonderful day out. He's done well. Perfect bike for a run round the Highlands. So thank you all for watching, until next time, bye bye.